what's going on, friends, family? My name is Skylint, and I'm always out there trying to find brand new games that are just weird, wacky, something new, something fresh. I just want to have fun with you. So one game that I think we can literally play together with all the time, nonstop, stream it and just jam, even make our own worlds, make our own mini games, and just, a stupid amount of fun, a stupid amount of comical ridiculousness is awaiting us inside of this brand new, what I would consider a hidden gem MMO, Blanco's Block Party. Now I say it's hidden gem because I think a lot of people aren't talking about it, or if a new trailer comes out, it doesn't quite really circulate through social media like I would expect a game like this to be. Now I think once it's actually released and streamers start playing it, and you know, YouTubers start having those reaction videos, and yeah, we saw what happened with Fall Guys, right? The meteoric, you know, rise to fame. Blanco's is totally going to be the same thing. It actually is. This Fall Guys the MMO, in a lot of ways, it's definitely emulating a lot of the core fundamental design decisions, obviously from an art style perspective, the color, the richness overall, and yeah, the physics, the wackiness of the game. You got weird cactus guns, punch guns, just really fun jumping around, sliding, literal slides, and just bouncing around, really. It's called Block Party. So basically, Blanco's is actually a couple of weird gimmicks. Okay, so just immediately, one gimmick is you can actually buy your own character. It says you can earn, so the Blanco's you earn and buy are yours to own. So I guess, you know, as you play through the game and as you customize it, as you earn these customizations or maybe purchase them, then you can actually download, like, you know, you have your character, you have your account, you can say, hey, I want my Blanco as a vinyl. They will produce a, like, you know, pop figurine for you. So it's kind of like, it's a pop figure thing, and it's a video game. I'm not saying this is like Skylanders or something like that, but it's taking a lot of trendy concepts that a lot of people really like, I think, inside of games. Like, this game is trying to really, it's trying to be collectible, it's trying to be memorable, it's trying to be a meme, it's trying, yeah, you know, it's very much trying very hard to be a viral internet sensation. And I think it definitely has the possibilities to be, but in the end, is it going to be the next Roblox? That's the next thing. Yeah, this game is going to be like Roblox. Now, it is trying to be an MMO. It's trying to be a living space, kind of like the servers, minigame servers on Minecraft, namely Hypixel. Really, this is like Hypixel mixed a little bit with Fall Guys and heavy inspiration with the customization from users from Roblox. Kind of mix those three games together and shake it up. Boom, you got yourself a Blanco's, you know, milkshake. Of course, almond milk or, you know, oat milk because I'm going vegan. But anyways, this is going to be a multiplayer game. It can be co-op, it can be PvP, it can be lots of different weird, wacky stuff because you can actually make your own adventures. Now, I do think that just immediately the base mini games and the base kind of world and kind of, I think that the vanilla experience is going to be fine enough. They really should jump in with some mini games and some worlds to explore, especially like maybe a hub town to jump around in. But we are going to have that Roblox experience as well, where players can make their own stuff and things, and I'm looking very much forward to that. In fact, I want to actually go back and I want to make a map or two, or, you know, an MMO maybe even inside of Roblox. Maybe I'll host my own server on Minecraft, and I really need to start just playing around with these tools because it's really awesome ways to interact with you guys or just make friends, period. Okay, so it is going to be like that. You are going to be able to kind of create your own MMOs inside of Blanco's Block Party, but of course with an updated engine compared to Roblox. That's really, I think, the main gimmick. Comparing it to Roblox is like, yeah, it is Roblox, but better. I mean, debatably. It's obviously like the art style is catchy, and it definitely looks way more polished. And the physics engine, I think it should be probably obvious, but like Roblox is kind of an older game. And I think with this title, it looks like it could actually perform much better. And I think a lot of people are going to be incentivized to actually make games inside of Blanco's versus Roblox just kind of for that, just for the art style. And then of course, when you actually make your games, your platformers, your jumping around games, your MMOs, if it all just runs smoother, people are going to be a lot happier. And then, of course, it's like the new game, but it does have to compete with Roblox. A lot of people don't want to leave Roblox. It is such a titanic game, and it is also on mobile devices with cross-platform playability. So it's a little weird to kind of go up against such a titan, but I think it can absolutely do it. Even if it does not, to the success, reach anywhere near Roblox, I think even as a niche game, this is something that I'm still incredibly excited for. So there is going to be, you know, you're going to be able to party up, you're going to squad up, you're going to jump into different matches that you can make or whatever. I don't know if you've ever played Roblox, but you can actually, you literally can make like entire games inside of Roblox with entirely different genres, from shooters, third-person shooters, first-person shooters. It can be a full MMO, RPG. It could be like some sort of little mini cooperative tower defense. Anything goes inside of Roblox. And also, if you do play a lot of the minigame stuff in Minecraft, I'm just going to go ahead and for the rest of the video assume you have played those and the specific very popular ones that I'm going to mention. But what I am looking forward to is maybe someone can recreate Royal High inside of Blockos. That would be great. But we haven't seen the creation tools yet. That is something to be critical about. I want to know that. Even Hytale, immediately their opening trailer, they announced, oh yeah, where you're going to be able to, you know, animate even in our tools. You're going to be able to make different maps, obviously, but you can even make your own creatures. You can literally make entirely different games, physics, and stuff. Yeah, I really want to see that, actually, Blanco. So if you could actually show a trailer of that, please, and thank you. But Blanco's overall, it's supposed to be like Roblox. I'm going to go ahead and assume that they're going to have at least everything that you can do in Roblox, similar systems, and then, you know, that's going to breathe a lot of fresh air into this whole, like, game-making space. We've had a few of those, actually, such as Dreams just recently announced, or, I mean, actually released, and a lot of people have been having fun with, like, Mario Maker and things like that, though some games have fallen away from the map-making scene, and stuff like Halo has really dropped that, I think, a little bit. Far Cry has dropped that, at least from the fame that they was used to be. So it's a little give, a little take. Is Roblox just like a meme of a game? You know, is it just a viral sensation? Can nothing actually take it on? I think this game could, just based on graphics, but it needs to have that freedom. It needs to have those tools. So it does say that you have infinite possibilities of games in terms of making your own rules. But is that to the extent of like Halo game making, or is it like Halo map maker, or is it going to be like a Far Cry map maker? It really should just be like Roblox. So anyways, a little bit of vagueness for that, I'm sorry to say. But anyways, just to kind of clarify once again, this is supposed to be sort of like a mini game MMO. So if you've ever played the most popular server on Minecraft, Hypixel, they are the ones who are actually going on to making Hytale. So Hytale seems to be like sort of like a different kind of vibe. It's kind of like an in-between of Minecraft and Roblox. I think this game is going to be that way too, but where Hytale leans more closely to Minecraft, I think this game is going to lean much more closely to Roblox. But it's still going to have actually the Hypixel vibe and feel, where you jump into a hub town and then you can communicate, talk with people, earn cosmetics and things, and, you know, as you play these mini games and jump into mini games. But then also some of those mini games or these servers are going to be open world. They're going to be MMO portions. And just like in Roblox, like Royal High is actually my favorite and one of the most influential MMOs that I have ever played. If I could even call that an MMO, I don't know. It's a thing and it's really freaking cool. So yeah, I do think you're going to have MMO potential with this game. I don't think it's going to be consistently constant, just like, oh, it's, you know, a giant kingdom and everyone's jumping around and silly. No, I think it's going to be a bunch of different mini games where, you know, it's going to be like 3-2-1 start lobbies, probably shooters. I mean, we can see guns. It's going to be platformers. It's, you know, parkour stuff, races. It's going to be all sorts of different games that we can actually invent. It's going to be all sorts of different kind of worlds and aesthetics that we can utilize. But I think it's going to look, at least in terms of aesthetics and game feel, just better than Roblox. Of course, being better on the block doesn't always make you more popular. So again, even if this is a more niche version of Roblox, I do think that I will actually favor this one just because of the aesthetic. And hopefully the tools are a little bit easier to use. And hopefully, I would really love if they actually promoted the crap out of this game. It does need a little bit more promotion. Oh, but here's a couple of questions actually to answer, maybe, because some of you guys are interested in, because this is the kind of game where it's like, it would be really fun to play with streamers, like actually play with me or, you know, as YouTubers, or play with your friends. Is this going to be a good game to play across the world? So firstly, yeah, kind of. It is going to focus on English-speaking countries. So that's going to be North America, UK, New Zealand, Australia, Canada, stuff like that. And they're going to also roll it out eventually. But it does seem like it's almost like a AA sort of kind of experience where they're rolling it out very slowly. Also in terms of consoles. So it is just focusing on PC for the beta, which is not yet announced. The game is pretty far off, maybe a little bit because of COVID, I don't know. But it's not, you know, this game isn't going to be readily playable instantaneously. Probably going to see it next year, though, and get excited for that. Or maybe you can get into the alpha or the beta if you actually sign up. You can sign up to the website right now, might get invited, might be able to join in some tests immediately. But yeah, betas should be coming, you know, soonish. They'll announce it soon, I'm pretty sure. but it is starting on PC. PC game focused first. And then I really, you know, they said that they're going to see what they can do later on when it comes to consoles. Stay tuned for announcements, but I'm pretty sure next gen, cross-platform, and maybe even, you know, I would really think mobile devices would really just sink Roblox's battleship. This game would really take off, especially with the question, is it free to play? Yes. Blanco's Block Party, the Fall Guys Roblox MMO, whatever, it will be free to play. And it's going to have, you know, option for purchasable in-game cosmetics, accessories, and limited edition Blancos, which I guess is just like a full skin, as well as the possibility of ordering that as if, you know, because they have a physical figurine that you can have and collect. It'd be kind of cool if you could actually maybe order like your favorite streamers, or maybe have all your friends, like, you know, you have your friends list, and if they see you can actually order your friends Blancos. That'd actually be amazing. Can you imagine if in the background of my streams you saw all of your own Blancos behind me as we played this game? I know that's such a weird gimmick, and it's obviously such a like a marketing thing, but at the same time, it is kind of fun. I mean, how many people would want that? Like, you know, your guilds and MMOs, your friends. How many times have you thought, like, you know, maybe I would want a figurine of my character? Or how cool would it be to have like your whole guild, you know, kind of like a Warhammer, like painted figurines across in the back of your bookcase or something? I think that would be pretty neat. But yeah, this is an MMO, and it's set obviously in this really ridiculous universe, and I think it's going to kind of blend genre definitions of what is and isn't an MMO, much like Minecraft has and Roblox has. So, you know, forgive me a little bit for just saying it is an MMO, because it's going to be like, okay, this part is the MMO, that part might not be, or what have you. But yeah, the Blancos is going to be the characters. They're little mischievous, little vinyl toys. They come to life. So in the game, like, everything is going to be toyish. Everything is going to be silly, larger than life. You know, some of the brushes, or I guess the objects in the game, they're going to be stuff like hot dogs, and then like clouds and unicorns, and just very cartoon. Very, I mean, you guys can see the gameplay for itself. And it obviously does target, I think, a demographic that is younger. But also, I think the style of this game, because you can make it whatever you want, is really fun for the whole family. And I want to end the video by saying that I think that this game, Blancos, I know it looks like it's for kids and things, and a lot of people would say that about Fortnite or Minecraft or Roblox, but if you really played those games and you enjoy them and you've went through that mentality switch, please leave in the comments below, say, hey guys, those games aren't just for kids, they're for everyone, and they're great, and they're awesome, and they're fun, and there's some really truly unique and ingenious stuff out there, some machinations that you have to check out, what people have devised. I'm telling, okay, again, the roleplay server Royal High on Roblox is legitimately innovative and emergent gameplay. And then also, if you've never played the most popular Minecraft server, Hypixel, you need to check out those mini games. They're a stupid blast. Okay, guys, and make some friends. So those, you know, those games, they're not just for kids. I don't think Blancos is just for kids either. Obviously, it's very search engine optimized, if I can say so, but I also think it totally targets my heart. What I love, what I appreciate about games, about coming together and, you know, just enjoying something new, or making something new, actually, with my friends and family. So yeah, I wanted to shout it out because I don't think enough people are. And here it is, little spotlight. And I mean little, I'm not a big YouTuber. I'm trying to get to 100K and I'm trying hard, and hopefully you guys can join me for that as well. Peel some eyeballs on the Patreon, YouTube stuff, like, subscribe, punch the all the buttons and description and things. But also definitely tell me what you think about this game in the comments below. And you know, again, try add my voice, add to my voice, and tell people, dude, guys, you gotta check out Roblox. It's seriously cool. And you know, in Minecraft, and shout out your favorite mini games, shout out your favorite servers, stuff like that. And hopefully we can actually join together and make something really cool. Have a good time in Blancos. All I can ask is you keep the hype alive. Hey, my name's Skylent, and I'll see you again next time.